बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स। दिस इज आवर नेक्स्ट मॉड्यूल, मॉड्यूल नंबर MECH_P_062_Douglas C. ज्ञान कोली स्टेटमेंट। ए कार ट्रेवलिंग 95 किलोमीटर पर आवर इज 110 मीटर बिहाइंड ए ट्रक ट्रेवलिंग 75 किलोमीटर पर आवर। हाउ लॉन्ग विल इट टेक द कार टू रीच द ट्रक। ओके, ए कार ट्रेवलिंग 95 किलोमीटर पर आवर, 95 किलोमीटर पर आवर ऑफ कार वाइल 75 किलोमीटर पर आवर ऑफ ट्रक। वाइल कार इज बिहाइंड द ट्रक 110 मीटर। ओके, हाउ लॉन्ग विल इट टेक द कार टू रीच द ट्रक। लेट सॉल्यूशन, लेट डेल्टा एक्स ट्रक इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस ट्रक ट्रेवल्स। ओके, वी हैव डिनोटेड डिस्टेंस विच ट्रक ट्रेवल्स बाई डेल्टा एक्स ट्रक एंड वी हैव डिनोटेड डिस्टेंस कार ट्रेवल्स बाई डेल्टा एक्स कार। ओके, डेल्टा एक्स ट्रक इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस ट्रक ट्रेवल्स एंड डेल्टा एक्स कार इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस कार ट्रेवल्स। इट इज गिवन दैट वी ट्रक एवरेज इज इक्वल टू 75 किलोमीटर पर आवर वाइल वी कार एवरेज इज इक्वल टू 95 किलोमीटर पर आवर। ओके, दीज टू वेलोसिटीज आर गिवन। हेयर बार इज टू डिनोट एवरेज। ओके, सो एवरेज स्पीड और एवरेज वेलोसिटी ऑफ ट्रक इज इक्वल टू 75 किलोमीटर पर आवर आर एंड एवरेज वेलोसिटी ऑफ कार इज इक्वल टू 95 किलोमीटर पर आवर, दीज आर गिवन। ओके, एज कार इज 100 मीटर बिहाइंड ट्रक सो डेल्टा एक्स कार विल बी इक्वल टू डेल्टा एक्स ट्रक प्लस 110 मीटर। ओके, क्वाइट क्लियर, बिकॉज कार इज 100 बिहाइंड द ट्रक सो डेल्टा एक्स कार विल बी इक्वल टू डेल्टा एक्स ट्रक प्लस 110 मीटर। एज कार एंड ट्रक आर ट्रेवलिंग साइमल्टेनियसली सो डेल्टा टी विल बी द सेम। ओके, इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम डेल्टा टी विल बी द सेम। वी नो दैट वी एवरेज इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एक्स ओवर डेल्टा टी। दिस इंप्लाइज दैट इफ यू टेक डेल्टा टी ऑन वन साइड देन डेल्टा टी विल बिकम इक्वल टू डेल्टा एक्स ओवर वी एवरेज। दिस इंप्लाइज दैट डेल्टा टी इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एक्स ट्रक ओवर V ट्रक एवरेज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एक्स कार ओवर V कार एवरेज। ओके, बिकॉज टाइम इंटरवल डेल्टा टी इज इक्वल सो इट विल अप्लाई टू बोथ ट्रक एंड कार। ओके, हियर we can say that delta t1 is equal to delta x truck over v truck and delta t2 is equal to delta x car over v car average. But because time interval is same, so both these quantities must be equal. Okay? Delta t is equal to delta x truck over v truck average, and this is again equal to delta x car over v car average. Okay, because time interval delta t is same for truck and car, so the relation delta t equal to delta x over v will be applicable to both car and truck. That is why this expression is valid, that delta t is equal to delta x truck over v truck. This is again equal to delta x car over v car. Okay. This implies that delta x truck over 75 km per hour, what we have done, we have simply put value of v truck. Okay. This is equal to, now we know that delta x car is equal to delta x truck plus 110 meter. So what we have done, we have replaced delta x car by its equivalent value, which is delta x truck plus 110 meter divided by v car, which is given in the statement 95 km per hour. Okay. This implies that delta x truck, if kept on one side, then this will alternatively become equal to delta x truck plus 110 meter, which was already on right hand side. We take it within bracket and multiply by 75 by 95. Dear students, here actually kilometer per hour will be cancelled on both sides. Okay, suppose we multiply both sides by kilometer per hour, because kilometer per hour are existing on both sides of equality, so we multiply both sides by kilometer per hour, so these will be cancelled on both sides. Okay, so delta x truck will remain on left side, while 75 will be multiplied on other side of equality, and 95 is already in the denominator. Okay, this is quite simple. Delta x truck has become equal to delta x truck plus 110 meter into 75 over 95. This implies that delta x truck minus delta x truck into 75 over 95 is equal to 110 meter into 75 over 95. Okay. Dear students, because 75 over 95 is being multiplied to both delta x truck and 110. So, what we have done, we have shifted delta x truck on left hand side. So, when it will be shifted, its multiplying factor 75 over 95 will also be shifted towards the left. Okay. This implies that in the next step, what we have done, we have taken delta x truck common. Okay. This implies that delta x truck common, in place of delta x within bracket, we will take 1 because it has been taken out. Okay. So 1 minus 75 over 95 equal to 86.84 meter. From where it has come? It has come by simplifying 110 meter multiplied by 75 over 95. Okay. This is just simplification. This implies that delta x truck into 20 over 95 is equal to 86.84 meter, because 95 will be LCM and 95 minus 75 will be equal to 20. Okay. This implies that delta x truck is equal to 86.84 meter into 95 divided by 20. Okay, because when 20 over 95 will be shifted to the other side of equality, its order will be reversed. Okay, 95, which is denominator in the left side, will become a numerator in the right side, and 20, which is denominator on the left side, will become 20, which is a numerator in the left side, will become denominator in the right side. Okay, after this operation, this implies that delta x truck is equal to 86.84 meter into 95 by 20. And this implies that delta x truck has become equal to 412.49 meter. Now, we know that time interval delta t is same for both truck and car, and delta t equal to delta x over v average is equal to delta x truck over v truck average. This is again equal to delta x car over v car average. This implies that delta t is equal to delta x truck over 75 km per hour is equal to delta x truck plus 110 meter divided by 95 km per hour. This implies that delta t is equal to 412.49 meter. What we have done, we have simply put the value of delta x truck, which we have found in the previous slide. Okay, the remaining portion has also been used in the previous slide. Okay, so delta t becomes equal to 412.49 meter divided by 75 km per hour. This is equal to 412.49 meter plus 110 meter divided by 95 km per hour. This implies that delta t is equal to 412.49 meter divided by 75 km per hour is equal to 522.49 meter divided by 95 km per hour. What we have done, we have added 412 and 110. This will become equal to 522. Okay. This implies that delta t is equal to 412.49 meter divided by 75000 meter over 3600 second. What we have done, we have converted kilometer per hour into meter per second. Okay. Why we have done? Because in the denominator, term is given in meter. So in the denominator, kilometer should also be converted into meter, so that meter will be cancelled out with meter and we will be left only with second S, which is our required unit, because we are determining delta T. Okay, this becomes equal to 522.49 meter divided by, again similarly we have converted kilometer per hour into meter per second, so it will become 95000 meter divided by 3600 second. This implies that delta t becomes equal to 412.49 meter divided by 20.83 meter per second. from where it has come? It has come by simplifying 75,000 divided by 3600. Okay. Similarly, right hand side will be simplified to 522.49 meter divided by 26.39 meter per second. From where 26.39 has come? It has come after simplifying 95,000 divided by 3600. Okay. This implies that delta t is equal to 19.78 second equal to 19.80 second. Okay. This is just simplification of these two terms. Okay. So, dear students, here time interval for truck has become equal to 19.78 second, while time interval delta t for car has become equal to 19.80 second. Actually, we have said in the start of our module that both are equal, and it has come true. So it has been counter checked that time interval delta t is same for truck and car. Okay, it has been now verified that time interval delta t in case of car and truck are equal, because 19.78 second and 19.80 second are exactly equal. There is a just this difference is only due to calculation minutes. Okay, otherwise these are exactly equal. Okay, so as 19.78 second is approximately equal to 19.80 second, okay, there is only difference of 2 second, which is quite negligible, and our assumption, our statement in the beginning of this module that time interval delta t will be the same for both truck and car has become correct, and it has been counter checked, it has been verified. However, there is a difference of only 2 seconds, which is just due to calculation error. Okay, so we take this implies that delta t is equal to 19.79 second. What we have done? We have solved this dispute by taking average of these two. Okay, time interval delta t for truck has become 19.78, while for car it has become 19.80. If we add these two terms and divide by 2, we take their average, then it will become 19.79. Okay, so we have taken the value delta t which we had to determine as 19.79 seconds.